Greetings, unsettled souls!
Go!
Go! Oh, wait, not just any normal go, but a particular and very important go.
Happy fucking birthday! Birthday,
yes!
Birthday, girl, birthday,
it
boy,
is my birthday!
Birthday, boy, birthday, girl, and, so, welcome aboard.
I'm doing a show on my birthday. It is January the 25th, 2017. If you leave a comment, I'll let you know how old I am. Donate to the show. How's that? You're allowed to start your show with donate to the show when it's your birthday, aren't you? All jokes aside, friends, it is my birthday. Sam I.V. DeGangi. With the Media Speaks, the Conservative Daily Post, also Blasting News, and the band Passing Time. Welcome aboard. Lots of news to get to. And if you do want to donate to keep the news going, it is thecorrectviews@hotmail.com. So, what's it like to have a birthday? Well, thankfully, I don't worry that much about it. I tend to get up in the morning and hope that it snows so that I can go snowboarding. When you hit the ground at my age, it doesn't feel any better than it did when you hit the ground when you were young. It hurt then, and it hurts now. RT, nobody's stealing your jobs. You spend too much on wars, Alibaba founder tells the U.S. Now, this story caught my attention largely because they're using an argument about something that is right, but using it to prove something that is wrong. People that are lying or being less than honest will oftentimes do something like this. You'll hear, I'll just use the example of what he is doing. No sense for an analogy on this one. Because America is in too many wars, we don't have a problem with China stealing our jobs by paying their workers slave wages. The two don't have anything to do with each other. We should not be in as many wars as we are in, and China is stealing our jobs due to slave labor. But the way that they're wording it, I must say, it is a rather clever way to pull off a lie if someone is really reading or even listening without really paying attention to what it is that's being said. I'm going to screen share here on the low def, and for you on high def, you'll be able to see it to my right. Chinese billionaire and Alibaba founder Jack Ma believes that improper distribution of funds and hyperinflated U.S. military spending, not globalization or other countries stealing U.S. jobs, is behind the economic decline in America. Now let me tell you, this is why you tune into the show. Let me give you a bit of insight here. What he is saying isn't making any sense. If America, and I hope that Trump does, if America brings home, let's say we have 40,000 troops overseas. I don't know what we really have deployed, but let's say we have 40,000 troops overseas. If we bring 40,000 people home and get out of all the foreign wars, we now have 40,000 more people who are going to need jobs while they're here, because they're not going to keep that many active duty during a time that we're not at war, particularly if things cool down between us and Russia with China. So, what he is saying is only going to exacerbate the problem that China has our jobs. So, you see what he's doing here? What he's doing is actually proving my point, which I love when people do that. It makes my job much easier. The Chinese business magnate earlier in January met with the U.S. President-elect Donald Trump, of course president now, who has bemoaned the loss of American industry and jobs due to outsourcing of labor to countries like Mexico and China. Ma, however, has a different view of what is behind the economic decline. Okay, now what he's about to say, again, he is right. A part of our economic decline is because we meddle in too many wars. But then again, who's talking about using nuclear weapons? China, not America. Who's talking about lining up the border of Pakistan with troops? China. Now, do I blame them? No, they're in that instance, they're fighting Islamic terror, but they're engaged in it too. They just put nuclear weapons on the border of Russia and China in a location that, due to the arch, could never hit Russia. So that's a sign of war against America. So China's acting like they're this peace-loving nation when they're knee-deep in this as well. Over the past, the Americans had 13 wars spending $4.2 trillion, said Ma, speaking at the Economic Forum in Davos. What if they spent a part of that money on building up the infrastructure, helping the white-collar and blue-collar workers? No matter how strategically good it is, you're supposed to spend money on your own people. Okay, that's very true. Does China spend money on its own people when it has people that are working at gunpoint to make your iPhone? Are they? Making what, $2 a day? Or as Jello Biafra says, a bowl of rice a day? At the other money, which I'm curious about, is that when I was young, all I heard about that America was Ford and Boeing and these big manufacturing companies. The last 10 years, all I heard about is Silicon Valley and Wall Street, he continues. And what happened? The year 2008, the financial crisis, he says, wiped out $19.2 trillion in the USA alone and destroyed 34 million jobs globally. So what if the money spent on Wall Street and the Middle East was spent on the Middle West and the Midwest of the U.S., developing the industry there? That could change a lot. Okay, that makes great sense. And when we change the industry, which I hope we do, just like you're saying, Mr. Ma, that involves not sending the work from that industry to your pisshole country, you stupid swine. What in the world are we going to build up industry for if, as soon as the industry is built up, we can feed it to you like a plate full of water chestnuts? According to Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, the United States spent $596 billion, or 3.3% of its GDP, on military expenditure in 2015, which is higher than any other country in the world. In Ma's opinion, this is partly responsible for the loss of jobs among America's Rust Belt. That's not even true. They sent the jobs away. Where would they work if they weren't in the military? Because China has most of our jobs is why a lot of those people felt they need to join the military. It's not that other countries steal jobs from you guys. It's your strategy. You do not distribute the money in a proper way. It is not up to the government to distribute money. Mal also expressed the view that overall globalization was a positive thing that had many benefits for both China and the world. Maybe for China, not the Chinese, that's for sure. China, he's saying, builds them wonderful bridges. Yeah, they're too poor to pay the toll or go across it. However, it should be improved by making more room for small businesses rather than the current system run by the NWO, which has developed to protect corporate interests. Well, China doesn't mind that when they're taking our corporate jobs that they say they're not taking. The WTO was great, but it was mainly designed for developed countries and big companies. There's no opportunity for small business. Well, that's been around forever. But in a communist country like China, where they dictate where you must work, what kind of opportunity is there for small business? This bonehead somehow founded Alibaba, one of the world's largest online retailers. I've never heard of them. And e-commerce platforms back in 99. Alibaba and the 40 Thieves. How appropriate. According to Forbes, Ma's net worth is $27.7 billion, making him the second richest man in China. Well, you know what? I'd like to see how much he was worth if he probably... I don't know for sure that he does, but if he didn't have American labor, and I bet you he does. And I bet you it's jobs that probably once flourished rather nicely here. Staying with China just for one more story. I'm not going to be on at all shows, so stick with me. Paramount gets China infusion. $1 billion, 3-year slate of co-financing deal with Shanghai Film Group and Hua Media. Now, here's the problem with this, friends. We are changing scripts at the behest of China. So China can make movies that talk about how wonderful it would be to blow me up here on my happy birthday. And nothing is wrong with that. However, since we have to now cater our films to a Chinese market, because we've roped ourselves into this globalism that he's speaking about. Well, now, if we write a movie where China is the enemy, like the Grisham novel that was made into a movie, they had to go in and digitally change all instances where it was a Chinese flag, because otherwise China wouldn't accept the movie into their country and we would lose money. That is censorship, friends. Okay, do you realize that is censorship? That is China censoring what the U.S. can do. And it'll go from entertainment on to bigger things as they continue to buy into our media. Now, if you go ahead and you add to that the fact that North Korea has all but threatened war over movies before, then it becomes very clear to see why foreign involvement in our movies pardon me, can be a bad thing. And our movies are tied to our news, and we already know that we're on a barrage of fake news sites like CNN. So you've got serious concerns here when something like this develops. Exclusive, Paramount Pictures has made its most significant long-term alliance in China since Viacom chief Shari Redstone nixed a 49% stake sale in Dalian Wanda for $4.9 billion last year. The studio has closed deals with Shanghai Film Group Corp. and Beijing-based Haohua Media for these companies to fund 25%, that's a quarter for you Usher fans, or more of the studio's entire film slate for the next 3 years, with the option for a fourth. What are they going to want for that money, friends? I can tell you what they're going to want. I can tell you exactly what they're going to want. They're going to want say over what it is that China... Well, China's going to want say over what could appear in U.S. movies. And they're going to want a real positive spin put on everything that China does while they starve, beat, and oppress their own people. The deal is worth a potential $1 billion in slate funds, which is retroactive to Par's fourth quarter films. It extends a relationship between the studio and Chinese companies that was already growing. Great. Already was growing. That's just wonderful. Where everything in America shrinks. The deal also will help Paramount with the release of marketing of its films in China. I bet they will. Shanghai United, the country's second largest distributor, will be very involved in censoring Paramount with the dating and distribution of its movies in China going forward. The prospect of a team-up in co-productions of Chinese films is also being eyed. This is being done because China is a communist country, and that is the direction that our leaders would very much like to see our country go in. Not Trump, but particularly the left, the Soros, Sanders, Clinton crowd. So, yeah, we do have nothing but McDonald's and no chance for Sam's hamburger stand to stand up tall. But that doesn't change the fact that China, to be giving that speech, when they're far more guilty of many of the same sins as we are, is ridiculous. The amount of money that China spends finding its own people makes it laughable that they would talk to us about it. Economic collapse, Michael Snyder. Why are Walmart and Boeing laying off workers if the economy is in good shape? Well, this was dated the 12th, but I kept it with me because I thought that it was really important. I'm no fan of Wally World to begin with. I should have had my Wally World shirt on right now. I absolutely hate the store. I got a Christmas present from, so thank you very much, for a gift certificate to, a gift card, I guess you should say, to Walmart. And I'm a nerd, I play Magic the Gathering, so I bought Magic cards, so at least I'm supporting a company, Wizards of the Coast, free shout out, that I really like. I hate this story. While we're on the topic of China, they cater to China, they undercut American goods, they undercut American stores. They'll find out what is selling really well in, say, Canton, Ohio, where I'm at. And they'll move in and they'll undercut the small stores. Put the small stores out of business because Walmart can afford to run at a loss. And then when the other places are gone, they'll simply raise the price on everything. And now they've successfully put mom and pop out of business. So I can say, in that aspect, China is correct, which is why we want Trump to take down some of these corporate shields that are up to prevent that from happening without us sliding into communism. It's a slippery slope. The stock market has been on a roll in recent weeks, but signs of trouble continue to plague the real economy. Fortunately, things are up with Trump in office. Earlier this week, I talked about the retail collapse that is sweeping America. Major retail chains such as Sears and Macy's are closing stores and laying off workers, but I didn't think that Walmart should be feeling the pain as well. Well, let's pause for a second. We covered the Macy's closing here, and just to recap real quick for those just tuning in, that's a little different because I had a gift certificate when I got married the first time. I've been married twice, to my ex. We couldn't find anything at Macy's we wanted. I mean, everything was just overpriced. I mean, it just looked no. Everything was no. And then if you did want something, they had an electronics department, a radio-controlled helicopter, it cost as much as a real damn helicopter, so you weren't going to buy it anyway. They don't have anything. They never had anybody want it. So, I mean, missing Macy's, I mean, I know it's a part of Americana. I know it is. We're going to talk about the Ringling Brothers closing insanity on the next Dunce Cap of the Month show. But suffice to say that Macy's had garbage. They didn't have anything anybody wanted, so nobody cared. Unfortunately, though, it says Walmart, that is precisely what is happening. USA Today is reporting that approximately 1,000 jobs will be cut at Walmart's corporate headquarters in Bentonville, Arkansas, by the end of the month. Another thing is, I don't care if it's a country or an empire like Rome, America has seen this, you can only grow so large. That's why England lost control of the settlers. You can only grow an empire so big before the economy, or in the case of countries, the people, correct it. That's why it's called a correction. Walmart's plan to lay off hundreds of employees in the latest ripple in a wave of job cuts and store closures that are rolling in from the retail industry. You know what? I'm sorry. I'm not upset that Walmart is closing. They are an absolutely despicable store. So, I mean, as far as I'm concerned, they can just keep on closing. The world's largest the company is saying that these cuts are necessary because Walmart is always looking for ways to operate more efficiently and effectively. Nice spin! Nobody buys it, but nice spin. But something doesn't smell right here. You didn't get rid of 1,000 employees at your corporate headquarters if everything is just fine. It is good to see that the average Joe didn't get the hose for a minute. But the Boeing instance here is rather alarming. But let's go stay with Walmart. I've driven past Walmart headquarters in Bentonville a number of times, and it's a beautiful part of the country. Bentonville and the surrounding areas have been booming, but it looks like the times may be changing. Well, if they're trusting Walmart, Wally World, as their great savior here, then perhaps, I mean, how booming could things have been? I was going to go ahead and give nothing on Google works, but that's all right. It's funny that Google's not laying off people, because nothing ever works here. Boeing has inherently announced a new round of employee buyouts for engineers company-wide, including in Southern Cali, and warned that layoff notices will follow later this month, and engineers in Washington State, where the company has a large presence. Management did not cite a target for the number of the projected cuts. So, Boeing's business, it says, is down following Wolf Richter. Business has dropped, as it says, has been tough in 2016. deliveries fell by 14 jets a year ago to 748 point net orders have dropped 13%. Well, again, when you have airplane companies building planes better than they've ever been built before, and when you have the FAA, which, I mean, I think we have security theater, as Alex Jones says, in this country. But when it comes to keeping planes safe in the sky, I think it's pretty safe to say that America has its act together. So when planes are being built better than ever before, and when planes are being maintained better than ever before, then planes are going to last longer than ever before. Is there a bad economy? Yes, that's why we got away from the Bushes and the McCains. That's why we got away from the Clintons and the Bernies and got somebody in there that does recognize this as a problem. Yeah, there's a lot of people that can't afford to fly. In many instances, in times in my life, would be one of them. From my last, I'm writing for the conservative Daily Post now, where I just did an article about California leaving the Union and how that might not be so bad. Yes, I said it. But there's been times when I've had absolutely nothing, and flying would have been absolutely just off the charts impossible. So, yeah, I mean, the hope here is that more people will be flying again. But that's not going to negate the fact that planes are holding up better. And, I mean, we should be needing less planes, because, thankfully, we've built an infrastructure, unlike what China says about us, that does keep our planes in the sky very, very well. We're not flawless, but that'll never be. Amazon.com, I go there, look up the day the lights went out. I've got two stories left for you. Don't go away. I just want to push this real quick. D. Allen Ross, The Day the Lights Went Out. Excellent, excellent, excellent book. It's just really funny. And it's sometimes hard to make a book that's funny. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy was one of them. It's actually a really good book and a dumb movie. But, oh dear, the movie's terrible. But the book is hilarious. Well, this D. Allen Ross, he manages to nail that. He makes a book that is funny. And it's rare. It's really rare. So look at it and donate to me if you'd like at thecorrectviews@hotmail.com, because it's my birthday. But I'm not going to spend it on my birthday. Nope. I'm going to spend it on the studio. I'm going to spend it on getting a camera that doesn't suck. That would be nice. I'm going to spend it on a lot of things like that. And I'll send you an autographed sticker and all kinds of good garbage like that if you want. Please donate correctviews@hotmail.com. Leave a comment saying you want to know how old I am. I'll tell you. On the eighth day, God made me. Yahoo.com, Azealia Bankis criticizes the Women's March and warns women about mainstream feminism. I have about as much interest in Azealia Bankis' music as I do a root canal with a pair of pliers and no Novocaine. However, she is absolutely on point here, and I would like to give Bankis props. Azealia Bankis is sounding off on social media again, and this time she's taking aim at Saturday's Women's March. We know. Take a deep breath. Again, Yahoo's going to condemn it because they're left to scum. The controversial rapper went to Instagram on Sunday criticizing the recent demonstrations and the mission of mainstream feminism. Bankis asked, "Why do women fail for all these white feminists trick all the time? Now that some white dude has taken office who simply said something silly about grabbing a pussy, they want to march in the streets under the guise of standing up for human freedoms." Well, even though she's making it race issue, everything through her is race issue. So we know she's going to be wrong on that. But she's right. She's absolutely right. Trump made a crude comment about a woman. Now, we know for sure, with the amount of, we don't know for sure, but with the amount of money that Trump has, we can pretty well assume he's had a very wide sexual past. He's married to a supermodel who has at least made pictures, which doesn't mean anything, that would imply that she is bi. Not that I care in the least. God, is she pretty. Okay. Now I digressed. He made a pink comment like I just did. Okay, fine. You got a pink comment. Hillary Clinton, who they're marching for that didn't get in, has taken money from Saudi Arabia, which uses blowtorches on the female genitalia for various instances, like walking down the street with a man that is not your brother, your husband, your uncle, etc. There's no logic here. And if it takes Azealia Banks, who really isn't the smartest crayon, the brightest crayon in the box, to color in the lines, then so be it. The 25-year-old then claimed that these marches do not express the same concern when police officers were gunning down black people last year. Well, maybe the black people shouldn't, or any other people, shouldn't be out rushing police officers after robbing a convenience store and beating up another minority, an Indian man. Yes, I'm talking about Brown. And then charging a police officer. I don't know, just call it a hunch. And that brings us to the Dummy of the Day. It's very rare that Azealia Banks doesn't get the Dummy of the Day. As I said, I'm not a particular fan of her. She was right for the wrong reason. There's always got to be something wrong in what she does. But I must say, she was right this time. About what then? Happy birthday to me. All right, it's the Dummy of the Day. There's the You Are an Idiot music playing now blissfully for everyone. Who got the Dummy of the Day? Of course, Dunce Cap of the Month coming at the beginning of the next month, where we send a Dunce Cap to someone. Anti-Trump crowd cheers as Madonna talks about blowing up the White House. Now, this is getting the Dummy of the Day because I thought about sending a Dunce Cap to Madonna. But I'm condemning what she said, by the way, so don't paint me as a loony here. I'm not sending her the dunce cap because I know what humor is. I get it. She didn't mean she was really going to blow up the White House or that she wants anybody else to do it. However, as someone who has made many comments like that, not like that necessarily, I didn't say I wanted to blow up the White House, but that has made comments that people will misconstrue as something I was serious about. Like, I think one time on air I said, well, it's real easy. If they're coming over in a hijab, they're not coming over. Obviously, that's a joke. Clearly. With that in mind, when you are speaking during an inauguration, and many people in America, as you know, Madonna, in large part thanks to your music, are not necessarily that intelligent. And if they're all hyped up, and they're all angry at Trump, and I know the feeling of depression, I watched it when Ron Paul got cheated, and you can look it up, it's a matter of public record in Iowa that he did. When that ruined his whole run, I get it. I understand what it actually bothers you when you care about your country, when you follow this kind of thing. When you've got people who have taken Hillary Clinton that seriously for reasons that nobody would ever understand, and you then make a comment about blowing up the White House, you get the Dummy of the Day, you dumb twat! Madonna's admission that she had thought about blowing up the White House was cheered by Women's March attendees. Let that sink in, Paul Joseph Watson writes. The other thing is this, is she gets the Dummy not so much for the ill-timed joke even, as the fact that she can't see that Trump is going to be one of the best things for women ever. He has women spokespeople. Katrina did amazing. What's the really nice black lady that was on his show? Her. He's talked about using her in upfront places in his administration. He's talked about, well, he's not just talked about, he's brought in people like Thiel, and a lot of homosexuals, which have latched on for God only knows what reason to the women's rights agenda. Madonna is mad because, and so is the whole left, that they're not hiring whiny leftists as spokespeople. Sarah Palin doesn't count as a woman, but Madonna does. I don't like Carly Fiorina. I'd rather vote for a dog, but Carly Fiorina doesn't count as a woman, but Hillary Clinton does. If you're not the right kind of woman, then you suddenly your vagina doesn't matter. But if Donald Trump talks about touching it, then it's the only thing that matters in the course of the whole election. Friends, you're listening to The Correct Views. Sam, I be the Gangi, signing off. Look up my work at the Conservative Daily Post. And remember to donate, if you can, at thecorrectviews@hotmail.com. I really want to get some better gear, particularly replace that camera. Good night, friends, and thank you for listening. Hit share, hit subscribe, wish me happy birthday, and God bless.